Hi, everybody. What is business trust? A lot of investors get confused between a business trust and a REITs. So today, I'm going to share with you what is the differences between a business trust and a REITs, and also what are the business trusts that are currently available on SGX. I get this comparison from REITs website, which give a very clear differentiation between what is a REITs and what is a business trust. First, both REITs and business trusts are constituted by the trust deed. However, for the REITs, the trustee and the manager are separate and independent entity. So the trustees hold the trust asset and the managers manage the trust asset for the unit holder benefits. But for a business trust, the trustee and the managers is a single responsible entity. That means the business trust manager is also the trustee for the unit holders. So this is the key differences between a business trust and a REITs. And for the business activity, the REITs is practically investing in properties and collecting rental income. So it's more like a passive investment. They just buy property, collect rental. Of course, they have a percentage they can go on property development side, but that will be a smaller percentage. The majority of the income must be from property renters. But for business trust, they can practically engage in any form of business activities, and even including doing the business operation aspect. And let's look at how is the trust structure look like for a REITs and a business trust. This is a REITs structure, MapleTree Logistics Trust. The manager is called MapleTree Logistics Trust Management. This is under MapleTree. But the trustee is under HSBC Institutional Trust Services Limited. So they are two independent entities. As HSBC Institutional Trust Services got no relationship with MapleTree Logistics Trust Management. So this is where they separate the manager and the trustee. And let's look at a business trust structure. This is Keppel Infrastructure Trust. The trustee and the manager is the same person. They are called Keppel Infrastructure Fund Management Private Limited. So the fund managers or the business trust manager itself is also the trustee. So these are the main differences. And the next part is if we are not happy with the manager, how to remove them? For the REITs, you just need a simple majority of unit holder vote at a general meeting, you'll be able to remove the REITs manager. But for a business trust, because it's a trustee and manager, it's wearing two hats, you need 75% of the unit holder to vote in favor of removing the trustee and managers. So it will be tougher to remove them out. And when it comes to when people start to invest in REITs, they will want to get dividends. People when invest in business trust, they presume they are also REITs. So they also want to get dividend. But for REITs, they must distribute at least 90% of their income to their unit holder, and you enjoy tax transparency. Some people say it's tax-free under the Income Tax Act. But for business trust, they are doing business. So they don't have this type of benefits. They just like any other company that listed in Singapore, they don't have that tax transparency benefits. So there's no requirement for them to distribute any certain percentage. But you see a business trust will want to pledge to distribute a percentage of their income to any holder. And people invest in business trust, they think, oh, I want to get dividends. So this is why the business trust, they will pledge. But it's not under the regulation they must give. And for gearing, we know that REITs, there is a limit of 50%, not 45%. And 45% is the old limit. The new limit is 50%. But for business trust, there is no gearing limit because they are doing a business. So you cannot cap a gearing limit for the trustee manager to determine how they do their business. But they themselves will self-impose a limit. Just a normal listed company, they also self-impose some of their limit, like some of their dividend policy. So this is the key differences between a business trust and a REITs. Now let's look at what are the business trusts that are now listed in SGX. The first one we talk about is Asia Pay TV, where their main business is doing Taiwan broadband communication. They've been listed in Singapore for close to 10 years already, and this is their performance since they listed in Singapore until today. Of course, it don't look attractive, but do think that this price chart is exclude dividends. The second business one is called First Ship Lease. So the name already tell you that they are leasing shipping vessel. Currently, they have 11 shipping vessels, mainly across three shipping sectors, what I call the crude oil tanker, or the product tanker, and the chemical tanker. So this is what they do. They lease out ship, collect income for leasing of ship. And these businesses have been listed before the global financial crisis. And this is the stock chart performance. And since the global financial crisis, the price never recovered. And it's actually on a quite depressing price now. But do take note, this is exclude the dividend you collected. The third one, which I believe that quite a number of investors have that, is called the Hutchinson Port Holding Trust. And they are mainly doing port business. Their port business are mainly in Hong Kong, Shenzhen, and Huizhou. And they also have some river port in the Guangzhou, Foshan area. So this is what they do. They are doing port business, and particularly on the Guangdong and Hong Kong that area. And how is the performance for this business trust since IPO? This business trust has been around for more than 10 years. And the charts also don't look that nice for this business trust. The fourth business trust, which is a very famous business trust and also created a lot of confusion. A lot of people always tell me that they have a REITs. Then I ask them what REITs is that. They told me it's Keppel Infrastructure Trust. So the fourth business trust is Keppel Infrastructure Trust, where their focus is on energy, where they are a cogen plant. And of course, they got environmental services that they convert waste to energy and also the distribution and storage side. So practically, they are doing what? Energy-related business. So this Keppel Infrastructure Trust, this business trust had also listed before the global financial crisis. This is a share price. And after the global financial crisis, it never recovered, but it's hover around slightly above 30 cents to 60 cents, that range. You have been trading within that range for the past more than 10 over years. The next business trust, which is a very popular business trust, it's called Netlink Trust. The main business is mainly doing fiber optic cable connect to all the household area or business area in Singapore. This business trust has been listed in Singapore about 5 years. And this is a price chart. It had a boom from 2019. Then after that, it's trade around $1 range since the pandemic until today for close to 2 years. The next two business trusts is more related to the REITs. And it always being mixed together as considered as REITs because they are property trusts. Their business is mainly on properties. They own properties and they collect renters. Okay, the next one is called the Dustin Retail Trust, which is a property trust that was IPO in Singapore about 2017, that period. And their main assets are practically shopping malls in China. And they collect rental income at the Guangdong area, which is why a lot of people always take them as a REITs because they are just shopping mall, but they are registered as a business trust. That means the trustee and the manager is the same person compared to other retail REITs where the trustee and the manager are separate entity. This is a price chart. And lately, there is some change of trustee and manager within these REITs and some refinancing matters. And we can see that the share price actually have plunged quite drastically in the past few months. And the last business trust, which is a property trust, it is called Ascender India Trust. So the sponsor for this business trust is CapitaLand. So what their focus is mainly on income producing estate in India. And it is registered as a business trust where the trustees and manager is the same person. But however, this business trust choose to adopt a REITs-like characteristic where they will follow the REITs regulations. That means they will invest at least 65% of the trust money into income-producing properties where they will distribute minimum 90% of the income where they set their gearing limits at 50 cents. So this is called a self-imposed regulation internally. That means that they are a business trust, but act like a REITs. So this is the last business trust. And this is a price chart. These trees have been listed before the global financial crisis. And from there, you can see a plunge at 08 to 09. But it had managed to recover back to the pre-global financial crisis high before the pandemic at 2020. But after that, it started to come down a bit. So this is the performance of these trees. Do take note, the chart I show is all based on price return. It excludes the dividend collected. So in summary, you can see these are the business trusts that is currently listed on SGX. And there is, of all these businesses, there is two property trusts that function like a REITs because their main part is getting property, collecting income and distribute out their dividends. Another type of trust that I want to talk about is called a stapled trust. They stapled the REITs and the business trust together as one, and they listed as one entity. But this entity itself got two trusts within them. One is the REITs and one is the business trust. And the REITs portion will function like a REIT and will be under the REITs regulations, where they need to distribute 90% of their income, where their gearing cannot cross 50%, where the manager and trustee have to be a separate person. But under this counter, it also have a business trust entity where the REITs manager is also the trustee themselves, and they are not bounded by the REITs regulations. So for investors that invest in this sort of counter, your dividends will usually from two sources. One is from the REITs operation side, one is from the business trust side. So there's two sources of dividend combined together, and that's the dividend you collected. You see the hospitality trusts are always structured in this form. And some of the business trusts for the hospitality REIT side is dormant. Why they need to structure in this way is for hospitality trust, their main business is mainly on hotel. And when they own the hotel properties, they rent it out to the hotel operator, like the Hilton Group, the Marriott Group. They operate the hotel, but the building belongs to the REITs. So they collect the renter from the hotel operator and pass on to the REITs investor. But however, if one day, if the hotel operator were to go into financial difficulty and or get out of the business, the building, the hotel will still need to be continued to be in operations. And when this situation arises, the REITs manager have to take over to continue to operate the hotel. And to operate the hotel, the REITs are not allowed to operate. So it need to be have a business trust to operate it. And this is why the REITs will always register themselves as a REITs and a business trust as one bundle when they go IPO at the point of time. And for this case, the business trust is always dormant until the operator runs into issues. And this is one type. But for another type of hospitality trust, the business trust is active. That means that besides owning the building, they also operating the hotels or the service apartment. And that is done by the business trust side. Let's take a look. And these are the five hospitality trusts, or you call the REITs that listed in SGX. Let's look at the structure. This is CDL, Hospitality Trust. The structure itself, there is a REITs portion, and the other one is the business trust portion. So the structure comes with two parts. So as an investor, when you invest in CDL Hospitality Trust, actually you're investing in the whole thing, the REITs and the business trust. And for CDL Hospitality Trust, the business trust is active because they are operating some of the hotels. So this is how CDL Hospitality Trust structure works. Let's look at another hospitality trust structure. This is Far East Hospitality Trust, where their hotel and service apartment are all 100% in Singapore. They got the master lease. That's where they lease out all the hotel and service apartment, and the manager will manage it. There's a business trust entity here, but this business trust is dormant. That means the five hospitality trust, the REITs manager never operate any of this hotel or service apartment. It just remains dormant. You only kicks in when the operator of the hotel or service apartment run into issues. This is what I call a stapled trust, and all hospitality REITs are registered as a stapled trust. And the last part is, these are the 40 REITs that's listed in Singapore. So all these are considered as REITs. So you see any of those trusts that is not familiar in, okay, they are not listed here. They are not considered REITs. They are under the business trust category. Where the hospitality trust, we can see that it's under the stapled trust category. So next time when you invest in a trust, so you have a better understanding of, are you investing in the REITs? Are you investing in a business trust? Or are you investing in a stapled trust? And hope that you have benefit from this video. Do remember to like, share, and leave your comment below. And lastly, do remember to subscribe and press the bell button so that you'll be notified on my next video. I shall see you in my next video. Bye-bye.